Hundreds of residents in Parkdale have refused to pay rent this month, fighting back against rent increases in their neighborhood. Now, tonight, they plan to take their action to the next level, and they're getting some support from allies.
We're trying to fight this as a unit, and I'd like to actually, first of all, get a big round of applause for those who are striking in June. That is amazing.
It's been a stressful month for 200 tenants in Parkdale who took the extreme step of withholding their rent this May. It was part of a protest against rent increases at 5 Metcalf buildings in the area.
There was a lot of fear surrounding eviction, but we've educated ourselves.
Striking tenants received eviction notices from Metcalf Living mid-May, but the group says knowing the process could take months to see through, they aren't ready to back down just yet. Instead, they're calling for more neighbors to get in on the action.
There's power in numbers, you know.
What we're hoping to do is to get some of those people that were maybes, letting them know that you will not be displaced from your home.
Metcalf owns 19 buildings in Parkdale. 5 of them are facing increases above the provincial guidelines of 1.5%. It's a tough blow for many of these residents who come from low-income families.
That the rent go up very difficult for me, yeah.
Metcalf says they're eligible to apply for the increases because of money they've spent on repairs to their buildings. But these tenants aren't satisfied.
We got a whole lot of new grass, painted the outside of the building, redid the front lobby. It looks nice on the outside, which is what Metcalf has done over the past few years, but there's still a lot of disrepairs, ceilings falling in, water damage in walls, mices, cockroaches.
Metcalf's CEO, Brent Merrill, says the company is working to complete outstanding work orders. We asked last week if he was concerned about rent strikes ramping up in Parkdale. His response:
I follow the rules of the government and all the rules that are required of me. I would hope my residents would do the same. But I guess if they choose not to follow the rules of the province, what can I say?
But it's not just tenants who are voicing their concerns. City News has learned teachers at Queen Victoria Public School have plans to picket next week in solidarity with their students affected by the rent increases.
That's great. We're getting, people are coming from the woodwork to show their support for us.
The tenants have also been getting financial support from across the country through a crowdfunding page for legal and administrative fees. These tenants say they'll need all the help they can get since they have no plans of backing down.
Hopefully with more voices and more people partaking, that message will be heard loud and clear.
Now, Metcalf will be meeting with the landlord and tenant board next Wednesday to make their case for the first of those 5 buildings that they've applied for increases above the guidelines, and the striking tenants say they'll be there too.